Eternal God, creator and preserver of all humankind, giver of all spiritual grace, the author of everlasting life, send your blessings on Christopher and Kara, and we bless in your name, that they live faithfully together, they may surely perform and keep the vow and the covenant made between them this day, and that they may ever remain in perfect love and peace together, and live according to your laws, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
You guests are invited here today. You're invited for more than just a meal after. I didn't tell you you could do that.
Sneak attack.
What?
You're gathered here today as witnesses, but in our society today, there's so much going on that I challenge you as guests to keep in contact with this couple. You know, this is a tremendous day for them. And as you all know, their lives have already been together. But there will be troubles. They're bound to be. I don't care who we are, we have. And there will be times when communication will be so important and they'll stop and fail to do that. And I challenge all of us to keep on top of it. When you don't hear from them, if you're close by, stop in and say, how are things going? If you don't hear from them in your distance, pick up the phone and call. Keep in touch. Because it is communication that is so important that we lack today. So I challenge you to enjoy your party later, but don't forget your covenant. For as much as Christopher and Kara have spent it together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and have pledged the faith to each other, and have declared the same by joining hands by giving and receiving the pledge of rings, therefore, by the authority granted to me as minister of Jesus Christ, I pronounce them husband and wife together. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together, let not man put asunder. Amen. Now you may kiss the bride.